Claudio Ragazzi guitar, Luchando, composed by Claudio Ragazzi. Thank you very much. Borges. artist, 30 years of his death, continues alive in the city of Buenos Aires, continues alive in making us think of it as a strange crisscrossed memories evoked with nostalgia, other countries, other places, other cities. People came to Buenos Aires from elsewhere, and they tried to found that elsewhere in the city, in the streets. That's why they hold such a fascination for everybody. They look like unfinished narratives that people have to guess. Borges was very fascinated by the city, and he gained his knowledge of the city essentially by imagining it. He led a very sheltered life. He was mostly kept home, and he imagined the city as populated by dangers, by very strong men who would die in knife fights. And he admired that. He admired that courage that seemed to him supremely exotic. For Borges, Argentina seemed exotic, and the rest of the world seemed home. So it is in that kind of zigzagging between home and between people who come from elsewhere with stories, mostly fleeing danger, fleeing the Nazis, fleeing being found out as having committed some crime, mostly crimes against humanity, that Borges found a voice for that very city. So it is like that, that we define neighborhoods, and that he inscribed his will to understand it with tango. He did not write tangos, he wrote milongas, but as we try to recover the texture of the neighborhoods of Buenos Aires, Claudio and Hector are going to give us a rendition of Sur, one of the neighborhoods of Buenos Aires. Thank you.
estación mítica de Buenos Aires. Y fue por este río de soñera y de barro que las proas vinieron a fundarme la patria. Irían a los tumbos, los barquitos pintados, entre los camalotes de la corriente Saina. Pensando bien la cosa, supondremos que el río era azulejo entonces, como oriundo del cielo, con su estrellita roja para marcar el sitio en que ayunó Juan Díaz y los indios comieron. Lo cierto es que 1000 hombres y otros 1000 arribaron por un mar que tenía 5 lunas de anchura y aún estaba poblado de sirenas y andriagos y de piedras imanes que enloquecen la brújula. Prendieron unos ranchos trémulos en la costa, durmieron extrañados, dicen que en el riachuelo, pero son embelecos fraguados en la boca, fue una manzana entera y en mi barrio, Palermo. Una manzana entera, pero en mitad del campo, presenciada de auroras y lluvias y sustadas, la manzana pareja que persiste en mi barrio, Guatemala, Serrano, Paraguay, Urruchaga. Un almacén rosado como revés de naipe brilló, y en la trastienda conversaron un truco. El almacén rosado floreció en un compadre, ya patrón de la esquina, ya resentido, duro. El primer organito salvaba el horizonte, con su achacoso porte, su habanera y su gringo. El corralón seguro, yo opinaba Irigoyen, algún piano mandaba tango desaborido. Una cigarrería sahumó como una rosa el desierto, la tarde se había ahondado en ayeres. Los hombres compartieron un pasado ilusorio, solo faltó una cosa, la vereda de enfrente. A mí se me hace cuento que empezó Buenos Aires, la juzgo tan eterna como el agua y el aire.
Buenos Aires, at any beginning, I feel it to be as eternal as air and water.
Thank you. Thank you.
The voice telling us the poem was the voice of Borges. The photography exhibit is by Juan Mandelbaum. Thank you. Well, that city, that place, those people fascinated Borges. And one of the explanations that he had for the way people acted was the Milonga. Well, Milonga names, gives its name to a musical form that you've seen dance and that you are going to see again. But it also is a poetry form. And Borges wrote milongas, and for him, the great puzzle was courage. Who had courage, and what do big people with courage look like? How could you actually become a hero? So Borges took actual characters from the city, from the chronicle of murders and fights, and he chronicled in his milongas these great men. He loved the way they wore the hat. He loved the way one of them spat through the corner of his mouth. And he also liked the way, above all, that they were able to lose their life in a knife fight, over a woman normally, or over something that the knives had against one another, but that was not very clear. So the milonga, which also means the place where you go to dance, a dance hall, was for Borges a way of recovering an art form, a form of poetry, making perhaps light irony of the density of the life and death decisions, mocking perhaps people he seemed to admire, writing, as he used to say, in seven levels. The one level we see puzzles us as much as it did him. Thank you.
You can bet your money it's true.
And dying, well, that's a common thing that people know how to do. And still, saying goodbye to life pierces me to the bone. Life that is such an everyday thing, so intimately known. I look at my hands at daybreak. I look at the veins, the pulse, with a queer feeling, almost as if they belong to someone else. Four final words will come, and then I won't know it anymore. Merlin the magician said it. Dying is having been born. So many things on the road of life were given these eyes to see. Who knows what other things after Christ judges me? Manuel Flores is going to die. You can bet your money that's true. And dying, well, that's a common thing that people know how to do. In keeping with its custom, the sun sparkles and wanes, sparkles and wanes. And in the patio, like the night before a yellow moon, but subtle time, which won't relent, affects all matters with its stains. The valiant have disappeared and left no hope, no seed remains.
Do not despair. In memory of coming years, we too will be uplifted as protectors and pioneers.
The pettiest will be generous, and the most craven will be brave. Nothing improves a reputation like confinement to a grave.
What has become of so much spirit? What has become of so many heroes? All alive beneath the mud and the clay. All spent by infinite tomorrows.
Thank you.
Momento el hombre se dijo: ¿qué no daría yo por la dicha de estar a tu lado en Islandia bajo el gran día inmóvil y de compartir el ahora como se comparte la música o el sabor de la fruta? En aquel preciso momento el hombre estaba junto a ella en Islandia.
Thank you. Thank you.